Good afternoon. Course title, Computer Design, Subject Code CS451, Topic, Syntax Analysis. In the Syntax Analysis, we will discuss about the LR parsing. Text and reference book are the same as the previous. Course outline. In this lecture, we will discuss about the introduction of LR parsing, property and structure of LR parsing, type of LR parsing, simple LR parsing, construction of parsing table, closure and go-to operations, canonical LR parsing, and the construction of CLR parsing table. In the last class, we have discussed about the bottom of parsing. In the bottom of parsing, we already discussed about a method shift reduce parsing. The next parsing is LR parsing. What is the means of this LR parsing? Here LR parsing means, here we have LRK. What is this L? This is left to right, left to right scanning. R means rightmost derivation, and this K means number of input symbols for the parsing. So this is the means of this LRK parsing. Then next is the properties of LR parser. LR parser can be constructed to recognize most of the programming language for which the context-free grammar can be written. The class of grammar that can be parsed by LR parser is the superset of the class of the grammar that can be parsed using predictive parser. Third, the LR parser works using non-backtracking shift-reduce techniques. So these are the property of LR parser. Next is the structure of LR parser. Here, this is the input buffer where the tokens are stored, and this is the stack. This dollar indicates that the empty of the stacks. If here this dollar represents the empty stacks. Here we are using the parsing table, where in this parsing table there are two columns. One is the action and another is the go-to. We will discuss when we will construct the parsing table. And here this is the parsing program. According to this present state and the input symbol, the parsing program take the decision according to this parsing table and generate the corresponding outputs. So in this structure, it initializes the stack with the start symbol and invoke scanner to get the tokens. These tokens are stored in the input buffer. It determines SJ, the state currently on the top of the stack, and AI is the current input symbol. Here, Here SG is the, here this S0 is the current input symbol and A is the symbols. So for this state and for this input symbol, the parsing program takes the decision according to the parsing table. So it determines SJ, the current state on the top of the stack, and AI is the current input symbols. It consults the parsing table for each actions SJ, AI, which can have one of the four values. So SJ means, SI means shift state I, shift state I. RJ means reduce by rule J. Accept means successful parsing is done, and if there is an error, then it indicates the error. So that is the syntactical error. So these are the four values in the parsing table. According to these, then the parsing program take the decision. Type of LR parser. There are three types of LR parser. One is the SLR, NALR, CLR. The means of SLR is S for simple LR parser. Simple LR parser. NALR, look ahead LR parser. And third is the canonical LR parser. Now see, in these three parser, in these three LR parser, or you can say ki, you can say which parser is more powerful. So this is the relative power of these parsers: SLR1, LALR1, and LR1. LR1 is also called CLR. So here the LALR parser is more powerful as compared to SLR, and then CLR is most powerful as compared to LALR. Means CLR parser larger class than LALR, and LALR parser larger class than SLR. So simple LR parsing. First we will start from the simple LR parsing. We have the context free grammar. So here, for this context free grammar, we want to parse using the SLR. So these are the three steps. One, construction of canonical set of items. First we will construct the canonical set of items. Then next is the construction of the parsing table. Then we will pass the input string, that is string belong to this grammar. If the string belong to this grammar, then we will get the accept states. So we will give the input string according to the parsing table. We will parse the input string and it will generate the outputs. So for the construction of the canonical items, we use these two operations. One is the closure and another is the godot. So for the construction of the canonical set of items, how can we apply the closure operations? So here this is the algorithm. So for a context free grammar, if I is the set of items, then the function closure I can be constructed by the following rules. So there are two rules. One, consider I is a set of canonical items, and initially every item I is added to closure of I. Second, if rule A is alpha dot b beta is a rule in closure I, and there is another rule for B such that B is gamma, then closure of I is A alpha dot B beta, then beta is dot gamma. This rule has to be applied until no more new items can be added to closure I. These are the two rules for the closure I. I will explain the whole procedure with the example. See the another operation, that is the goTo operation. The function goTo can be defined as follows. If there is a production A is alpha dot B beta, then goTo A alpha dot beta B beta comma B, so that is A alpha B dot beta. Here in this case, this is the shifting of dot one right hand side. That means simply shifting of dot one position A hat over the grammar symbol. The rule A is alpha dot B beta is in I, then the same goTo function can be written as goTo I comma B. Now see the example for these two operations. Consider the following grammar. S is AA, S is BAC, S is AA, BAC, BC, BB, A is D, B is D. Compute closure I and goTo I. See, first I zero is S is dot AA, S is dot BAC, S is dot BC, S is B dot BBA, A is dot D, B is dot A. Now we will apply goTo on every goTo on each symbol from state I0. So goTo I0 comma A, goTo I0 comma A, that is equal to I1. I1 is goTo I0 comma A. Now for this A, according to the goTo, so this dot is shifted. S is A dot A. S is A dot A. Here A is a terminal. Next is I2. Go to I0 comma B. Go to I0 comma B. So here S is, now see, for the B there are two productions where the dot is before the B. So here S is B dot AC, S is B dot BA. So in this production before the dot here there is a variable and here also a variable. So we will add the two productions of this. A is dot D and B is dot D. So this is I2. Next I3, go to I0, comma, what is the next symbol? A, B, next is capital B. See, here, this capital B, before the dot, here, so there is only one, so here we can write S is B dot C. Next, I4 is go to I0, comma, D. For this case, here A is D dot, B is D dot. In this way, we can compute the closure I and go to I for any context free graph. So now this go to operations are clear. Next is construction of canonical set of items. Here for the first rule, for the grammar G, initially add S dash is dot S in the set of items, mean the grammar is augmented grammar. Second, for each set of items, I in C, and for each grammar symbol X, add closure I, comma X. This process should be repeated by applying go to I, comma X for each X in I, such that go to I, comma X is not empty and not in C. The set of items has to construct it until no more set of items can be added to C. So these are two steps. So we will apply these two steps for every rules of the context free grammar. So here what is the use of this? Here we want to construct the SLR. So in the SLR, the first is construction of canonical set of items. See the example. We have the productions E is E plus T, T E is T, T T multiply F F T. F E F I. Now we will get the canonical set of items. So what is the procedure? The procedure is the same. Apply the closure and go to operations. So first, for this grammar, this is the grammar. According to the first step, make the grammar augmented. So here I zero is E dash is dot E. Then E is dot E plus T. T E is dot T. T T multiply F T dot F. F dot E and F is dot I. This is the I zero. This is the I zero. Now compute the I one. Apply the go-to rules. So what is I1? I1 is go to I0, E. Here, go to I0, E. So what are I1? I1 is first shift the dot one position, E dash is E dot. And another equation is this, shift the dot, E is E dot plus T. So this is I1. This is I1. Here this is the terminal. Apply the same thing. Go to I0, next is T. I0, T. I2 is E is T dot and T is T dot F. This is I2. Next is go to I0, F. I3 is, this is the equations, T is the F dot, this is the production rule, I3. Next I4, next is I4, go to I0, F is over I0, this. I4 is, for this there is only one equations, F is this dot E this. Here before, after the dot there is a variable, so we will add the production of this variable E. So add E is dot E plus T, and for this E is dot T. Here there is another variable T, so write the rules for T. Dot T multiply F and T is dot F. For this F there is another rule, F is dot E, F is dot I. So this is the I4. Next I5, go to I0, ID. Go to I0, ID. I5 is F is ID dot. F is ID dot. Next is, now this I0 is over. We applied the go to for every symbols. Now see for this I1. So apply the rules for this I1. Go to I1 comma. This is already completed. We want to shift the dot at the last. So here we have this plus. So here the rule is I6 is E plus dot T. T is another symbol. So add the rules for the T. T for the rules T. T is dot T multiply F. And T is dot F for this F dot E, and for this F this is ID. Next, I7. This is over. Next, this is I7. Go to I2 comma multiply. So I7 is for this multiply T is T multiply dot F. For this F there is root. F is dot E and F is dot ID. Next, go to this I2 is over. For this I3 already over. Then for this I4, apply the rules for this I4. Go to I4 comma first symbol is E. For this I4 E, I8 is F is E dot. E dot and E is E plus dot T. Then see in this case if we apply go to I0 comma T, then same as I0 comma T, same as I0 comma T, T dot, same as I2, and go to I0 comma F, I0 comma T, I0 comma F, same as I3, then go to I4, this is I4, this is I4, I4 comma this symbol, I4 comma this, so again this is the same as I4, and go to I4 comma ID, same as I5. So we will not add this again. Then I9, I4 is over, then I5 is already over. Then next is go to I6 comma T. I6 comma T. Here E, so this is I9, E is E plus T dot, and T is T multiply F. Then go to I6 comma F. Go to I6 comma F, same as I6 comma F, same as F dot I3, same as I3, and go to I6 comma this, same as I4, same as I4, and go to I6, comma this ID, same as I5. Then I10 is this I6 is over. Next is I7. Go to I7 comma F. So this is T dot F dot. Then again for this, again the same. Then next is I11. Go to I8, this, and here this I11 is F is E. Again these are the repetition of the previous. So finally we have the sets like this. If we have the sets, can we construct the DFA for this set? Yes, we can construct the DFA. For this set, we can construct the DFA. See how can we construct the DFA. So analyzing all these rules, these are the canonical sets we computed in this way by applying the closure and go to. So these are the canonical sets. And we can construct the grammar. We can construct the grammar. We can construct the DFA. Here I0, I1, I6 all are the states, this represent the states. For this I0, if for the E, the next is I1, then plus I6, I9. Like this, I0, go to I0, I1, like this, I1 plus then I6. This is I1 plus, so what is I6? In this way, using these canonical sets, we can prepare the DFA. In this way, these are the repeating states. Say in this I6, for this I6, here this is F, then this is the repetition of the previous state, so I3. So like this. So we can construct the DFA using the canonical sets. Next, the second step is we want to construct the parsing table. For the construction of the parsing table, first is construct the canonical sets of items like this. Second is the parsing actions are based on II. The actions are given below. If A is alpha dot A beta is in II, then go to II comma A II, then set actions dot I comma A as shift of J. Note that there must be a terminal symbol. See, here in this grammar, after the dot, we have the variables or we have the terminals. So if we have the terminals after the dots, then apply the shift operations. Rule number 2a. If we have the variables, then apply the rule number 3. If the production is like this, A is like this, E is T dot. If the production is like this, then apply the rule 2b. We will calculate the follow of E, and for every symbol in the follow of E, we will use the reduce. Then S dash is S like this, E dash is dot E. For this productions, entry in the table and in the action parts I comma dollar is accept, and all other entries are defined as the error. So we will apply these for every canonical set of items. So this is the table. So see the table. This is the I0. This is the I0. This is the I0 for the same example. This is the context free grammar. For this context free grammar, this is the I0 canonical sets. Now see the entry in the table. First we require the follow. So what is the follow of E? Follow of T and follow of F. Follow of E means here, see the variable E in the right hand side, E and E. After this E, we have a terminal plus and we have this. So this is the follow of plus and this. And you know that E is the starting symbol, so add this dollar in the follow of E. Next, follow of T. So what is follow of T? Here T and this T. Follow of T means follow of E. So follow of E as it is plus this dollar. And then from this productions, we have this terminal after the T. So this terminal is also added. And here from this follow of F is follow of T. So same as this. Now see the entries. How can we make the entries? First take this. F is dot E E. Compare this with A is alpha dot A data, where A is equal to F, alpha is null, and A is this, beta is this. Then which rule we will use for the construction of this? Here alpha dot A beta, alpha dot A beta, apply this and see ii comma A is ij here. So in this case, go to ii means I0 comma this, I0 comma this. So what is I0 comma this? I0 comma this, so that is I4. So here this is I4. This is I4. So action I means 0 comma this is shift 4. Shift 4. See the entry in the table. Action 0 comma, this is action 0 comma this symbol shift 4. Next is this rule F is dot ID, same is compared with A is alpha dot A beta. Same, go to I0 comma ID, I0 comma ID, see the rule, I0 comma ID, so that is I5, so that is I5. So action 0 comma ID is S5. Zero comma ID is S5. So in this way we can do for every terminals all shift operations. See for the variables. For the variables, for this E, E is dot E plus E. For this rule, go to I 0 comma E equal to I, see I0 comma E. So what is I1? So here we will write action 0 comma E, so that is 1. Like this, E is dot T and for this go to I0 comma T. So what is I0 comma T? That is I2. So action 0 comma 2, so that is 0 comma T, so that is 2. Like this, T is F, T is F, then go to I0 comma F, So that is I0, comma F, that is I3. Action 0, comma 3 is 3. 0, comma 3 is 3. So say the table for this E1, T2, F3. So that is the in the Bodo. So these are in Bodo. All the variables are in Bodo and all the terminals it contains S or R, shift or reduce. See the example for the reduce. For this reduce, we need this type of production. A is alpha dot. In this case, where is this production? E is I2, good. For this I2, we have E is T dot. See the rule for this. Here, compare this A is alpha dot. Here A equal to E, alpha is T. So first calculate the follow of E. Follow of E. Follow of E is plus this and double. So now apply action. Here this is 2, 2 comma plus action 2 comma this action 2 comma double. I2 comma plus for this I2 comma plus I2 comma plus for this I7 then I2 comma this for this E. I2 comma plus, what is I2 comma plus? Follow of E. So this is for plus 2 comma plus, so that is R2, action 2 comma this R2, R2 according to the rules 2B, according to the rules 2B. Next, rule number this, E is T, E is T, here we are using E is T, so that is R2. 1 is rule number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. For this plus, rule is R2, for this, rule is R2, for this dollar, rule is R2. So here we will, now you can see in the table, for this 2, for this plus, this and this, so these are the rules I R2. Now we have one is for augmented grammar. So that is the 2C. In this 2C, we have the production like this. E is E dash is dot E. E dash is dot E. So that is the augmented grammar. For this I, so this is action. This is in I1. So this is in I1. Listen, E dash is E dot. So this is in I1. So action 1 comma E. So that is equal to $1, $1. So that is equal to asset. So in the table, see in the table, $1, so that is asset. $1, so that is asset in the action. In this way, we can fill the table. Next is parsing. Parsing the input symbol using the parsing table. Start from $0, ID, and this is the input string that belongs to this grammar. 0, ID. First 0, ID, that is S5. See in the table, in the parsing table, 0, ID, so that is S5. So we will use the shift operation. So here operation is shift. Here this ID is shifted in the stacks 0 ID5. Now for the next is 5, multiply. So see in the table. So what is 5, multiply? So that is R6. So use the rule R6. So what is the rule R6? R6 is F is ID. So use this. Here 0, F is 3. So this ID is replaced by F. So 0, F is, so what is 0, F in the table? 0, F, 0, F is 3. So here this is 3. 0, F is 3. So write 0F3 and this. Again 3, multiply. So that is R4. Apply the rule R4. So in this way we can parse the string. See here we have this 10, plus. Here 10, plus, that is R3. So what is R3? So what is the rule R3? R3 rule is this, T into T into F. So here we will use T into F. This. So this T into F is replaced by T. So this is T. So 0, T, 0, T, 0, T is 2. 0, T is 2. 0, T is 2. So here, so that is 2. And in this way, we will repeat the same steps, and the finally we get this 0E1. Here the string input buffer is empty. There is no other symbol in the buffer. And here this is asset. Here we will apply E plus T. E plus T is E. And here $1. Here $1. Next is $1. $1 is asset. So we get the asset. So in this way we can pass the string then that belongs to this grammar. So in this way, using the SLR, we can pass the input strings.